Assalamualaikum and welcome to Radio Sabka Saath, and you're listening to Weekly Dose with Arjanam. Yes, you're on show and you can participate, and your participation is must. You can participate in my show by joining our Facebook page, that is Facebook/Sabka Saath. And you can also give us your feedback in comment box. So, howdy doody, and what are you up to after long lockdown? And it was also good that we had break from hustle and bustle life, where we could stop and think about our lives. And we spent precious time with our family members. So back to the format of my show, and that is some riddles and my book. Wow, because I like this book, and it's called The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. We have studied 3 habits of this book in my previous shows, and today I'm gonna talk about the 4th habit. Before moving to that 4th habit, I have a riddle, and that is, what stays in a corner but travels all around the world? Wow, think about this and answer this riddle in the comment box. We have so many comments and answers of my riddle. I'm so happy that you guys are listening to my show, and you are also thinking about my riddles and commenting the answer of my riddle in the comment box. So in the previous show, my riddle was, what has lots of keys but cannot open any door? Yes, answer is piano. Sanarshad commented piano, and also Oves commented piano. Yes, this is right answer. And also Ruman commented keychain. Yes, keychain itself cannot open any door. Yes, that is also right answer. In previous show, Salim asked a question, and the answer of that question is 7. All right, think about today's riddle. That is, what stays in a corner but travels all around the world? Think about this. I have another riddle as well. I'll ask you in a while. Speaking of that lockdown time when we all were doing work from home, so it was really good experience. We learned many things from that, and Naisuba produced many informative and beneficial stuff like these shows that we have started uploading on YouTube, Naisuba channel, and you guys are liking it because our shows are infotainment, mixture of information and entertainment. As you all know that we are reading a book, and that is The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. And we are going to talk about the 4th habit, and that is think win-win. If we say think win-win, what first thing comes in your mind? Let me know in the comment box. Let's see what Stephen Covey states in his book about think win-win. Covey argues that win-win is not a technique. It's a philosophy of human interaction. It's a frame of mind that seeks out a mutual benefit for all concerned. This means that all solutions and agreements are mutually beneficial, and all parties feel satisfied with the outcome. Life must be seen as a cooperative, not competition. To be an effective win-win leader, Covey argues that you must embrace these 5 independent dimensions. And what are these? Let's see. First independent dimension is character. This is the foundation upon which a win-win mentality is created, and it means acting with integrity. There is plenty of everything for everyone. We all should always remember this line. One person's success doesn't threaten your success. If we start thinking like this and adopt this habit, that is, think win-win, we surely stop pulling others' leg. But most of the time, people don't think like this. Second independent dimension is relationships. Wow. Trust is essential to achieve win-win agreements. You must nourish your relationship to maintain a high level of trust. Third independent dimension is agreement. This means the party involved must agree on the desired results. Fourth independent dimension is win-win performance agreements and supportive systems. Creating a standardized, agreed upon set of desired results to measure performance within a system. Wow! Do you agree with that? I'm sure you all agree with that. Fifth independent dimension is processes. All processes must allow for win-win solutions to arise. So this was Think Win-Win, fourth habit from the book 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. So do you have this habit, or you always try to pull others' leg? So what do you think about this? Let me know in the comment box. You can also join us on our Facebook page, that is Facebook.com/SabkaSaath. And my riddle, next riddle is, what belongs to you but used by other people most? Comment in the comment box, answer this riddle and let me know. About your habits, what do you think, which habit do you have and you think that makes you effective? My first riddle, I ask you again, that is, what stays in a corner but travels all around the world? Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and you can share it as well. See you in the next show with next habit of Covey's book and new riddles. Allah Hafiz, take care, bye bye.